Hi guys, welcome or welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me. Today we're going to go ahead and look at a professional tip on how to make your images pop far more than they already do. So like I've just said, basically today we're going to look at a pro technique. It's one of the many ways to do a dodge and burn, and we're going to walk through what the heck that is, why you should use one, and why it will level up your images tenfold. So yeah, let's get into it. If you're new here, then please do consider hitting the subscribe button. If you're gonna hit the subscribe button, you may as well hit the bell icon. The bell icon will help you out, it'll give you a notification every single time I upload a YouTube video. I upload every single week on a Friday at 12 noon. The reason for this video basically is because in my previous video, which I did when I was really feeling woo-woo, is because I mentioned that one image would be better with a bit of dodge and burn. Probably a little bit more of the old dodge and burn contour going on up in there. So like I said in that clip, this image would be improved tenfold if the image had a little bit more in terms of the depth and the punch and the grit and just basically some edge that would come through. And so that's what we're going to look at today. We're going to use this image of Arthur that we've got up on the screen. Arthur was photographed last week? Was it last week? I don't even know. I've got no idea what day it is at this stage. And this has been edited. So we're going to do the steps to get from here that we can see to here. So that's the after. And those little bits will elevate an image from something that looks just like a normal photograph to something that looks oh so much more. If you're doing studio photography, if you're doing human photography, if you're doing animal photography, if you're doing any kind of photography, including landscapes, then this technique is going to work for you. So I'm going to utilize the technique that previously was discussed in full edits on the YouTube channel. We don't have full edits on the YouTube channel now. In fact, them and all of the other ones since are all inside of our premium membership over on the website. So full edits are living there right now. I think there's like 18, 19, 20-ish. And we do a live Zoom full edit every 3 months as well, which people really enjoy taking part in. In that, we did utilize a slightly different technique for dodge and burn, which is what I use personally now within my workflows. But this technique is a really good one to get you started. So how do we do it and what do we do and what the heck is it? Let's start with the last one first and go with what is dodge and burn. So dodge and burn is essentially a technique that you apply to your photographs in any editing software. It doesn't have to just be Photoshop. And what it does is it lightens certain areas and it darkens other areas. When we use the term dodge, we mean lighten. When we use the term burn, we mean darken. So by utilizing both dodge and burn, we lighten and darken areas of the image in a very structured, specific way, because we're in full control of that. Unlike using something like the contrast slider or the clarity slider, which is fine, but what that does is does a global adjustment. And this is not a global adjustment. It's a very specific, minuscule, pointy little kind of effect, right? Okay, so yeah, we're gonna kind of just jump into it because there's no point hanging around. I need a cup of tea. Tea is so good. Okay, and grab a Wacom pen and we're gonna walk through this, okay? So today I'm gonna use the Wacom Intuos Pro Medium. It's my personal favorite in terms of the choice of the size. I still do use my keyboard shortcuts because personally I just prefer it. So I don't like using the key things, we're not fully with them just yet. So yeah, so I've got this image of Arthur up, like I said, and what we want to do is go ahead and apply a contour. We've finished the edit. The before of the image looked like this. This is the after. Okay, so everything else is done, but he has not had anything done to him, right? Nothing is happening on him. It's all going on in the background. So what we want to do is really just have a look and see how we can improve this image by utilizing a dodge and burn technique. Now, the one that I'm going to walk you through, let's start with right now. So the first thing that you're going to need to do is have the image open in Photoshop. And then we're going to go ahead and go down to the new layer icon down here. But we're going to go ahead and hold down Option on the keyboard. If you're on a Windows, that is Alt. So we're holding down Option or Alt on the keyboard and we just click once on the new layer icon and we will get up this little box here. So in this box, we want to title the layer as contour. I call this contouring. You can call it dodge and burn. Just do whatever you want. I don't care. So we've got a contour on here. We're going to change the mode, okay? So this is a little mode drop down. And we're going to go ahead and change the mode to overlay, right? And this is the reason, this little step next, this is the reason why we go ahead and we add a new layer in that method. Because otherwise, we can't get to this box. So this box is really important. An alternative way of opening up the new layer dialog box is to do a shift command N or a shift control N on a Windows. So we're going to go ahead and fill with overlay neutral color and click OK. What that's done for us is if you look over here, we have a gray layer. Okay, so it looks completely gray, but it's see-through. That's only because it's on overlay. So remembering our blend mode basics, if it's gray, we think overlay because overlay is basically operating on the fact that it's going to make middle gray invisible. So we're on a gray layer. If Photoshop is terrifying for you, I probably should have said this earlier. Go ahead and look at the Photoshop basics video that's above. And if that's still not enough, then go ahead and have a look at the Photoshop for Beginners online course, which is over on our website. So yeah, let's go ahead and have a look at this. So what we want to be doing is just having a little bit of an assessment of the image. It stands to reason at this stage that you should have correct white balance, correct exposure. Everything's looking really good. The image is fine, a little bit noisy. Maybe we could run through Topaz Labs Denoise AI to remove the noise. I'll go ahead and link a video on that above. In fact, let me just run it through it and then I'll be back in a sec. Okay, so now that we've got no noise happening in the background, thank you very much, Topaz Labs Denoise AI, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and look at this contouring. So we want to go ahead and click on our contour layer, making sure that that is selected, okie dokie, and then we're going to grab our brush. You get to the brush by pressing B. I just like doing it that way. It's just so much easier. Or you can go ahead and click over here on the brush icon. Then what we're going to do is make sure that our palette is set back to the default black and white. We can do that by pressing D on the keyboard. D for Dan Dan, okay? D for Dan Dan. So what we're then going to do is go ahead and make sure that we've got the correct size. I'm going to zoom in a little bit closer onto the eyes so that you guys can see this nice and clearly. I always start my dodge and burn around the eye. I just always do, and I always start on white. So I'm going to press X to flip my palette so that I've got white up on the top there, and then I need to change the brush size. So to do that, I'm going to hold down Control and Option on the keyboard, and then click and drag to make my brush smaller, larger, softer, or harder. Okay, so it's just those two little handy keyboard shortcuts. We've got two videos of keyboard shortcuts for Photoshop. Go ahead and look at them above. So what we're going to do now is focus on a nice little brush. We want it to be nice and soft, and we're going to put the opacity to 20%. Again, keyboard shortcut in use here. So then what I'm going to do is just start to ring around the eye on the areas that are naturally highlighted, okay? So that's really, really important thing about dodge and burn is that you're not wanting to redraw the image, right? You're not wanting to reinvent the light that was there originally. What you're doing is you're using your tools, your dodge and your burn, your light and your dark, your white and your black, to go around and kind of accentuate the light that was naturally there in real life, okay? So this light that we've got up here, you can see, let me switch to a different tool here, that we've got an area of lightness here, and then next to an area of darkness. That gives us our perfect line here so that we can accentuate with a burn and accentuate with a dodge. And doing that around the image is what makes it successful. So what I'm gonna do is go ahead and continue. You don't need to be too perfect, but a good control would be beneficial, okay? So I've gone ahead and done the catch lights there as well. Really, really important to have them done. Just gonna back that one off a touch. Very, very important that they are the lightest part of the image, okay? And then we're gonna have a, probably drop to 10% now. So I'm gonna go to 10% opacity, keeping the brush the same size, and I'm gonna go and start to lift the iris, okay? So I'm gonna just start at the bottom. I'm not going too much further, and I'm lifting at the bottom area around here, okay? Then I go ahead and start to map by changing my brush size, okay? So for larger areas, use a larger brush. For smaller areas, use a smaller brush. And what we're going to do is we're just going to follow the natural highlights and shadows all over the subject, okay? So don't be super specific to one area. Like, for example, don't only do the eye. You want to go around and follow the natural highlights for every area of the subject. Don't go over the edge of the subject because it will just look wrong. It looks like you've ruined your mask and we don't want that. When you've done your fine detail, there's a little bit on the ears that we probably could do a little bit more of. But when you have done your fine detail, and I will show you the speed at which I usually contour at this stage because nobody has so much time to do really slow contouring. So what we want to be doing is going around doing all of these little highlight areas. And then what I would usually do, okay, just like as a top tip, because I did start on the head, but I'm not going to kind of go there next. I'm going to switch to black. And whilst we're down here on the body, I'm going to start to do my burning. Okay, so now we're following the natural shadow. Okay, so we've followed the highlights. Now we're following the natural shadow. We're going to go ahead and just accentuate again what is already there. We're not reinventing the light. We're just drawing with what is in the image. If 10% is too strong, you can always drop to a lower percentage, that's fine. So I'm just going around again, just following the natural shadows. Natural shadows. We're not reinventing it. I feel like I've stressed that enough by now, so I'm not going to say it again. And do the pupil, okay? Top tip, actually do it. Don't forget about it. Okay, so I'm going to just stop here because there's no point really continuing any much further along than that. So this is the image now. We're at the final stage. We're running along the final mile and that's the end. This was the before. This was the after. This was the before. This was the after. Look at the complete transformation in the image. It is a photograph that has been dodged and burned. It is not a photograph that has been heavily retouched, okay? Before, after. Look at the definition on the body, after. Look at the definition on the face, after, right? I can't stress the importance of doing this enough. Like, it literally will transform your images from start to finish. So that's your contouring. If you were wondering, the layer looks like this, okay? So this is what a dodge and burn layer looks like. When you basically take everything else off, you can see that it kind of just looks a bit strange. The face looks interesting. But then if you turn the rest of your layers on, it starts to make sense. And there's no reason why you have to stop there. You can use your brush, as I often do, to go ahead and actually add a little bit of a vignette coming around, because you can just go ahead and Painty McPainterson on there. You can go ahead and contour your objects in the image, which is something that I do as well reasonably regularly. So that is my pro tip of the week. If you want more tips, go ahead and check out our premium membership where you guys get like a lot more. I'll let the premium members explain why membership is so amazing. So I'll just leave that to them guys because those are super anyway. This was dodge and burn method number one. There's a lot of different methods. I will be doing a demo on dodge and burn at the photography show. So if you'd like to come and see us in Birmingham at the NEC with some or one of our dogs, we're unsure yet, then please do make sure that you put that into the diary. I'll put the dates on the screen right now. And I think that's it. Love you guys. I'll see you soon.